Good afternoon. My name is Prince Comrade Olusola Adegboye, the chairman of Human Rights Defenders and Access to Justice Advocacy Center. By the special grace of God, I am the Oluomo of Alimosho, Shasha, Lagos, Nigeria. For those who will be joining us for the first time, this is a campaign we started over a month ago. It's a campaign against some ambassadors, top immigration officers, because we have been receiving a complaint in our various offices, complaining from abroad, mostly Italy, Spain, Germany, France, etc., even in the US. How Nigerians are being maltreated, not by the foreigner, but by these so-called immigration ambassadors, staffs, and all that. So immediately I arrived Italy, they took that advantage to lay more complaint with evidence to me. Even videos were there. How pregnant women with a little baby, people with disability are being maltreated, molested, beaten, dragging out, and there was video for that. So we, the Human Rights Defenders and Access to Justice Advocacy Center, we took it upon ourselves. And the first contact they could release was somebody of Hajar Larai. Yes, we know that Hajar Larai was not indicted in their complaint. But for the fact that he's the only number made available, we thought we could talk to Hajar Larai to enable her link us with the appropriate body or person. Not even knowing that the ambassador himself is just few days or weeks old there. But meanwhile, it doesn't matter whether you meet problem, you need to solve problem. You must not be the creator of problem before you resolve it. So trying to talk to Hajar Larai, according to her, she's answerable to the top officers there or somebody. So she refused to talk to us. So in the process, we were talking about how she herself felt she is the one that we are reporting against. So although publishing her and her phone number gave us full access to access the embassy, which we did and find out that the problem can be resolved. Meanwhile, she and the new ambassador, they met that same problem, and the problem has been existing for years. Promising that things will be fine, then the things started, they started putting things in place, and we were seeing it. I paid a visit undercover. I saw things were going good, and the people that used to call me on daily basis, they were also calling to tell me things are fine. And passport that have been delaying for so many months, weeks, they were releasing passport, and the crowd there were becoming lesser. But then we get to find out that they are short of booklets. Booklet doesn't come the way they want it, and it come in a less quantity. So, what do we do now? The people there, they have been working 24 hours, even they work on Sunday, to make sure the complaint of the masses is being attended to, is being resolved. But now, no passports. To get passport from Nigeria booklet, it's like you are trying to allow the head of a lion to pass through the eye of needle, which is impossible. Now we need to talk to the immigration control general of immigration. This man is not giving us access to talk to us. This man is not giving us access to talk to the world and say, yes, it's true that we don't have enough. It's true we have enough, but we need help. Let's talk to federal government. This man is feeling that that place is his father's house. A person of Mohammed Bambadede. Mohammed Bambadede is taking this job to be his personal business. This is the picture. So Mohammed Bambadede feel untouchable, feel above the law. He don't want to talk to the government, to the public. He don't want to talk to the citizen. He don't want to give hope. He said he doesn't grant an interview to the press. Who are the press? What do you mean? Does he give a grant interview to social media? Who are the social media controller, General Bambadede? Who do you think you are? Every problem is being accumulated from a different places, from different offices. Problem of Nigeria did not just start from Aso Rock, did not start from the police, did not start from the immigration, did not start from call it, whatever you want to name them. All these problems, they are being gathered, oppressing the citizen in your little way, in your little office. You oppress everybody. You don't owe anybody apology. You don't owe anybody interview. You don't owe the nation. You don't owe no citizen explanation. What a country. Okay, now, if the complaint from various country embassies and their staff is they complain that they are short of booklets. But for the manpower, they have enough manpower to work. They are even working 24 hours. And if we have to call a spade a spade, remember this is business. You are the Nigerians, both home and abroad, they are entitled for their passport, is the identification. But meanwhile, we are not being given for free. It's business. So why not respect us as customers? If you cannot respect us as citizens of Nigeria, you need to respect us as customers. We pay for this. We are paying for this. Somebody will put in a passport 8 months, 6 months, 3 months at least, you will not get it. You have paid. It's not free. And if not, like we go in toto, we will always think all the problem is for agent, is from staff, is from this, is from that. Why this man, they swell up for face? You see, he be like who them born for inside moon. He they swell up with our money. This man have the guts to say he cannot address this issue. Who do you think you are? Dan Brubaker, you did not even deserve that position to start with. You did not deserve that position, even with your name. You did not merit it. You never worked for it. You did not work for it. You say you are not coming to the media. I have dragged you now to the media to come and talk to the world. You are there hiding. Where did you go to your training? How did you get to this position? How did you get to this position that you have turned to your own? Controller General of Immigration, Mohammed Bambadede, how did you get here? People deceive people. That you now see that office like now your father's house. I not go fit drive you away from your father's house. I not go fit drive you away from your mama's house. I not go fit give you command to go leave you alone. Is that what you are thinking? To hell with you. It's not your father's house. With Nigerians all over the world, we can get you out of that office. We can give you command to go because it's not your father's house. This man is the cause of the whole problem immigrants are getting from the whole world, from the entire world. This man, Immigration Control General, person of Mohamed Bambadede is the problem immigrants are facing. If you are an immigrant, whether immigrant or not, if you are having problem with your passport being delayed, no booklet, this is the root of the problem. As it is swell up for face, so. If they swell up for face like person, when they born for inside moon, when sun never touch with our money, you are not, instead of this man to be serving us, we are serving this man. Everybody, they cry. Buhari, Sai Baba no good, Hi Baba no good. Shall not Buhari be this man? This is not Buhari. These are the people that spoil the country, one of them. This man don't want to talk to the press. He don't want to address Nigerians. And he don't want to provide. You can't even come out to say, okay, I can hear you, I can feel your pain. What you should understand, we are doing something about it. Meanwhile, it's not even my fault. Federal government, they are not giving me the chance to operate. You just say you know they grant interview to the press. You must be depressed. You will be depressed with this message. Okay, now the protest and the campaign is that we want this man to leave that office. This man should leave office. Controller General of Immigration is the cause of all the problems we are facing both home and abroad. He should work for us. We are not to work for him. This man need to work for us. This man need to work for us and he's supposed to work for us. This man, I am not asking you for booklet again. I am asking the federal government to drop you because you are not serving us. We are the ones serving you. This man is not serving Nigerians. So home and abroad, make una see una problem. Oh. All of una when they go queue for embassy. Now this man been a problem. Oh. This is your problem you people have. Oh, I beg. Anywhere on a day, now this man be no problem. Now inter say will not be anybody. Now this man no. This is the problem we have in passport setups. And as clueless as this man is, incompetent as he is, he did not even know his left from his right. In the sense that he's supposed to know that where to send 1 million passports to, where to send 1,000 passports to, booklet, you don't even know it. Because if you know, you will know anything that have to do with Western world, European, stroke, even America, they enter, majority enter from Italy. So now, you cannot give, you are not supposed to give Italy 1,000 and give Switzerland 1,000. That is where you know people who know their job. This man don't know nothing. Even most people who travel to Europe, I mean, UK, Switzerland, Denmark, Dublin, America, or even Australia, most of them enter from Italy. They enter from Italy, they grab their passport from Italy, and you know many of them did not come with passport, they trash it. Many did not even leave Nigeria with passport because they passed through river. So, Nigeria immigrants in Italy, they are much more than the daily people we receive in any immigration center in the 36 states in Nigeria. If you take a very look at what I'm saying, today now, give us, I mean, statistics, the numbers of people that are queuing for passport now in 36 states of Nigeria. They call Italy. Call Italy today and ask the numbers of people that are queuing for passport only today, Monday. You will see that only Italy is more than the numbers of 36 states in Nigeria. So if this man, to say he know his job, You know, say anybody when they rear cow, if your brother dey for that office, he can come out in Nigeria and wear immigration and become a controller general. Are you not aware that custom, the control general of custom was not a custom? This is the country we find ourselves. So I am very much convinced now that this Mohammed Baba Dende did not go to this training. He must be related to somebody in that Nigeria to become this position, because you cannot be an animal rearer. All of a sudden, you want to be controlling immigrant when you don't have a clue about immigration. So if this man really go to that school and know what his job is all about, he must know the population of every immigrant that arrive in Italy that have been documented. Yes, you're supposed to know that even the month of July, we receive so-so immigrants in Italy through the, you know, through the passport session. We received 2,000, alone. You're supposed to know in Holland, people that put in, that indicate in our system, only in July, there are 500. In Switzerland, there are 300. In UK, there are 600 or 700. This is what this man supposed to know or do. Then now, if we have in 3 months in Italy, we have people who put in for their passport up to 6,000 in 3 months. You are supposed to send 10,000 passport there that will be in reserve. So as soon as they consume these 6,000, we still have 4,000 left. You should be preparing to send another 5,000 there or the same 10,000. What we are supposed to be complaining about now is how to have more people, manpower to work. We are supposed to be complaining of we are short of manpower, we are short of immigrations, we are short of this and that. This is supposed to be our complaint. It's a shame that our complaint is now we are short of booklets. How can you take 2,000 booklets to where they have already awaiting 6,000, if not be an humanity? When will Nigeria start putting people that matters in a position? We are in animal country. A country where Controller General of Custom is a retired army. He will send over no more of your home. I am very much convinced, without me being investigating this matter, this man has no clue about immigration history or what immigration is all about. How do you now mistakenly arrive in this position of a control general of immigration? A leader should be like Buhari. How can a leader be like somebody that lives in the moon? That means you are not feeling our problem, you are not feeling our pain. That means you don't even talk to the media. But problem everywhere. While light are like the thunder, when he go punish you, he is doing push-up. Oh. He is doing push-up. All these people, when they cause us pain. He's doing push-up. Oh. For this man to look this good, that means he's not feeling our pain. He can't even talk to the media. He's short of strength. A true leader should be like Buhari. All this place will go inside. He go they sick always. They'll say he won't go to medical checkup, because if he hear say this thing happen, he will shock. If he hear say that thing happen to citizen, he will shock. If he hear, I'm not saying I make Buhari the sick, but that is how a true leader is supposed to be. So a true leader is supposed to be like, say, he get sickness because he's always concerned about his citizen. until he leaves that position, he will never know peace, because there is no peace in the land. That's so true leader supposed to be. A true leader is supposed to be like Barack Obama. When Barack entered presidency, Barack was like, oh, a very young, active guy. After 1 month, when he defeated the problem, they cry always in the visit. Obama was forced to grow gray hair and very tiny and slim and lean self. How can a leader with big problem be like this kind of man when he be like Bobozi? He be like bread when he fall for water. He refused to talk to us. Refuse to talk to us because we are in a lawless country. Because we are in a lawless country, this is the man that caused problem all over the world. The problem we are facing, this is the man. And what I'm telling you now, I want this man not only to fix that issue, but to step down. He have to step down. The fixing of the issue will no longer be the solution. He need to step down. His name is Mohamed Bambadede, Control General of Immigration, or Immigration Control General, however you're gonna put it. He need to step down. Oh, he's not doing his job. Oh, this man need to step down. Oh, he's not feeling the pain of the citizens. Oh, citizens, he's not feeling their pain. This man need to step down. He don't have strength to talk to the public. He don't want to. He don't owe anybody explanation. He's too big to serve Nigeria. The man is too big to serve Nigeria. He has to step down and leave it for those who can listen to us, who can attend to us, who can even come out in public and address issues. There is problem in that country, Nigeria. Let him step down. In a civilized country like our Nigeria, we are civilized. If we say Nigeria is not civilized, that means me are not civilized. You not civilized. Are you not civilized? If I'm civilized, then my country is civilized. I am old enough to rule that country. You are old enough to rule the country. We are civilized. Let them talk to them. Let us talk to them. Don't always say we are not civilized, we are going backward. Hey, now then they go backward. Me, I can never go backward. I am more than civilized. So you have to hear me. You have to behave civilized or step down. But now step down is the only way. It's the only way. So wherever you are, the protests have started now. I know, say, some mumu people, because everywhere you must get mumu. Among three children, say one, the mumu for inside house. But if I say mumu, you know yourself. Some mumu people, now negative word, they will start now because they don't get their red pali, they don't get passport, nothing concern me. If something, when it concern, when it not concern you, concern your family. If you're not stupid, you know, say concern you. So now let's go every of your Facebook page. Put there, Controller General of Immigration, person of Mohamed Babandede, put it there. And go to Google, look for his picture with that name, put it there. Then protest against him that he is the cause of the shortage of passport all over the world. And he refused to address it. So let's go there. I want in few minutes, when I drop, I want to see it in each and every one of your page. I want to see it there. This is the man behind the problem. This is the man behind the problem. This is the man. This is the man behind the problem. Yes, that is the man behind the problem. So, here I'm going to stop. God bless you. And the next person to take over his position should know why this man stepped down. So you have to do better. There must be enough booklets. If you cannot solve it, cry out, grant us interview, so that you tell the world that, yes, it's not me. This is the problem. But because he refused to grant us an interview, so he is the full trouble. Because if you grant an interview, you must tell us why we should not hold you responsible. So if you say you don't care, that means you are the problem of the whole world that immigrants are facing. So let his picture be everywhere. Let his name be known. He wants to be popular in this manner. So let him come out and address us and step down. He's a servant. I don't understand Nigerians. All these people now serve, and if you know the meaning, that's why when you are supposed to come and talk to them. Leaders are servant to Buhari, now your husband, President Buhari is our husband, errant boy. Anybody that choose to go to position is an errant boy. Me, when I day, and I'm an errant boy, even despite that is an NGO, independent. I am an errant boy. When you say a father in the house is an errant boy, you see people say, "Father, I can't carry that, help me carry on." A leader is an errant person. So this man, not the left position of anybody, they fear you. Waiting here. Controller General of Immigration Nigeria. Say that big man. No, a leader is not big. Don't be confused. Don't be deceived. A leader is an agent. A leader is a servant. A leader is not a ruler. It's not supposed to rule us. Now we the rule leaders. Yeah, that makes us different. That makes us go, you know, backward. Because in Western world, leaders, they are agents, they are errant people, errant boy, messengers. So don't allow any position to flick you. Hey, controller general. Hey, wow, controller general. No, they are our errant people. So the message we send this man now, he no go, he need to come back. Yes. Yes, he no go. He no go message. So we now, when we send now, we say make him come back. So he have to come back, you know what I mean? So here we are going to stop. This is the campaign now. We use this campaign to replace Abakiare's, or you know, say now today Abakiare campaign supposed to start. So now this man, I'll tell you, pray some more. Any problem when you they face, or you not get problem, now your friends get them, or now your children they not give passport. Now this man, no. All right. Okay, I remember Prince Comrade Olusola Adegboye. I know I'm going to answer this query. Very soon you will see me in this meeting. I fear no bagger. If I come, save this video, not the delete video. If I come, the one player to me, that they say, see what I talk. Mona see player to me, that the day I will come. I will come and face you one on one. And everything I said in this video is what I'm going to say. Everything I said in this video is what I'm going to say to you in your eye like this. One, you are our servant. You are there to serve us, but when you say you know we'll talk, that means you want us to serve you. We refuse. Water when they take the wash head, now leg they come. Water when they take wash leg, you know they come head. Now when be leaders be the water when we take wash head, now down I suppose they go, and now down love now we'll go. Yes, now we be head, now leaders be leg. Get this clear. Now we the masses, poor or rich. Now we be head though. These leaders from councillor to presidency, now they be Lego. So whatever one we take wash head, now down they come. The one when they take wash leg, you know they come up. That means anything when we talk, now it's supposed to work, and I would they work, so shall it be. One love. You know they will come for you. You know they will come for you. Now today discourage. I know be Jesus Christ, I know be Muhammad though, but you get where we will do this human rights work, reach this one and they say hey, they know that will come for me. I'll come become who I am. I'll show you my real picture. I know how many person push me start to Don't push me, star. This one, I know they'll come for you. I know they'll come for you. See, I am not doing this activism for anybody. But if you want me to show my strength, I will do my activism. Believe me, I will do it. Mo, leave that one. I'm not here to boast for anybody. Not here to boast. Where these people dey when I not dey? You know me. But leave that one. Where then dey when I not dey? Think say I shove belle full finish, my belle tight, now I come dey do activism. If you want and soft, we do and soft. If you want and hard, where you dey, my person go dey dey if I not dey there. Oh, leave that thing. And after all, nobody is ordinary person in that Nigeria's post you are seeing. No. All of them get where they put their heads. Not be only gone, they shag them. They get where they put their head. But me, I believe, say my head self dead here, but I not say anybody. Oh. They get where they put their head, though. Me, I don't want to change this activism for now. Coming off now that they claim this, claim that. Now, just they paint, now say white here. I don't want to change that for now. If I want to change that for now, now, you know, say the small body, when sit down here, they do activism, eh? He get where he finish when some of these leaders not finish, oh. Mona, leave that thing, you know. Mona, leave that thing, you know. I laugh in that language. As we speak now, embassy in Italy is one of the best places as at today, less as at yesterday. After our intervention, they serve the man serve public now. He say, I'm a servant, who I am. You call me, I will say I no answer. Person call me, I say I no answer. He say no. He say, I'm here to serve you people. If to say immigration not there here, yeah, which I want to do here, therefore post me. The man humble himself. He not just humble, he swing to action quickly. The man swing to action quickly. I go there about 2-3 times. What I saw there with my eyes, it was amazed. Everywhere just normalize. They create one room, they put handicapped people with disability, and everybody, they just respect them like say, now today, life start for there. What else are we talking about? You talk to messengers, they understand, they suppose. They are messengers. They are errant people for us. So that is how every ambassador is supposed to behave. That is the man. The man tell us he's a servant. And he actually behaved like a servant to us. All those people, when you see there, you see some of them be like, say, they're there for village. Now, some of these street boys, they hustle how they want to eat. The man allow everybody. He allow everybody come, you know, talk with him, they want to talk. You see, when you call a leader, because a leader that know himself, his or herself to be a servant, will respond. Cannot be you put yourself there in a very normal country like that. You suppose no say, not be you put yourself. You understand? You suppose no say, not be you put yourself here. I call you, you will respond. That is the man. The ambassador in Italy. I no call her. I call somebody else, but he have to call me back. He say, I'm the ambassador in Italy. I heard that you were talking about my priest. Priest, I want to see you. I went. When this man begin to talk, I say, God, this kind of people still day in Nigeria. This man should be given another opportunity to that is more than this position. He not finished there. He's not finished there. And you know, they stay in the office, they work everywhere, they outside, they work everywhere, they ask people questions. Are you okay? What is your problem? He give out his number. And come on. Just call her now. If you not pick in 1 minute, in the next 3 minutes, your phone will ring. This man will call you back. You know, as my phone don't fool testimony, they call me, okay? Now the person I just called direct to see what he just talk and it don't happen. They don't give me, they don't do this one. He don't beg me, say sorry. We now this one make us so. You know how many call I don't receive since our intervention in Italy, Rome? Is that not how leader supposed to be? Is that not how to lead? No, the man no will take for there. Before you know it happened, they'll say, he won't tell us, say he good. He won't tell public, say he good. They'll come out. The man no will, I not swear for him, no will take for there. Because they'll see him like enemy now. They'll see him like enemy. So now you want to show, like, say, you are a servant to the world. So we now, you want to make them say, we not be servant. The man no go stay long there. But who cares? If now one day you stay, that legacy will lead you and your children. I cannot force anybody to act. One is inborn. Two is determination and passion. You must be passionate about anything you are doing. The field that you are passionate in, I cannot operate in that field because I'm not passionate about it. What you are determined to do, if I don't have the determination, I can never do it. So we are all unique in our various place, our various life. In our different angle, we are all unique. Nobody is useless. We are only begging you people, inviting you people to our feed, to assist us, talk to the government. Doesn't mean it's your feed. Doesn't mean you can do it better. I cannot operate in your feed. Nobody is useless. Even if you carry deaf and dumb, you give the campaign board like this, protest board. Give them protest board like this. Enough to be talking, but you have to go home. Is that person not useless? Is that person not useful? Is the person useless? No.
You will just hold on. You can hold on. You hold on like this.
Already now you write waiting there, say stop killing. Stop the killing in Nigeria. You give them
in better. You say hold on.
That space is covered. The media will come and read it. Nobody is useless. We are all useful. What we lack of is unity in Nigeria. We are lack of unity. We are lack of understanding. We hate to see people progressing. Jealousy, envy. That is just our problem in Nigeria. Otherwise, we are all useful. Nigeria is one of the richest countries in the world as we speak now. We are complaining of hunger. There are hunger in many European countries, not to talk of African countries, but there is no hunger in Nigeria compared to how the government frustrates us. Everybody can provide for themselves. The problem we have in Nigeria, we all want to be a millionaire, not even millionaire, billionaire now. So our problem in Nigeria is competition. We are not really hungry, despite the fact that we are left out by our government. So cool down, let's do this together. I love you guys. All right, the time is off now, so I will be back in few hours time to attend to a case of landlord and tenant and bobo-tibo. My husband slapped me. He don't leave my PK. You know now our identity. All right, let's go there. God bless you.